least the past 6 years. Yeah. And Gentle Whisperings was the first person that I ever listened to. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. What the heck? Listen to it every night since. I'm not kidding. I've listened to it every night since. I have to listen to it every night. It's like my sleep. Sometimes I'll listen to it, even just like throughout the day, you know, just because I want to like chill. But yeah, who inspired you to do ASMR? Honestly, no one. I just thought, like, I want to help people, so I'm gonna start one, and I did, like a year ago. Occupying your mind lately? No answer. How old are you? I'm 23, turning 24 this year. What kind of music do you like? Guys, I love R&B, like, oh, Take Me to OVO Fest, like, that is my gig. I'm not even kidding. I'm not into pop. I'm not into radio stuff. Like, I like old school hip hop. Like, I love rap. That's what I work out to. It's just like, makes me feel bad. Like, Betty. This is like so weird to some of you guys, because you're literally gonna be like, WTF, but I love worship music. Like, I'm Christian, yes. Oh, I'm pretty sure that's one of the questions on here, but we'll get to that. But I love worship music, Bethel and Hill songs. Man, Take Me to Church, like, praise the Lord, like, break all the feels. I love Bethel. Yeah, Amanda Cook, amazing. Stephanie, great. I forgot her name. Jeremy Riddle, yeah, so good. But then I like rap, and like, you know, the bad ones. I know it's not good. Anyways, okay. Does it hurt to get your lips done? I'm thinking about doing mine. Do it. Whatever. It'll dissolve if you don't like it. Or you can get it dissolved for free. Like, literally, if you don't like it, they will dissolve it for free. Like, anyway. Yes, it hurts. It is a needle going into your, like, look up. There's so many things on Instagram that you can see. You can see them doing it, like, yeah, it hurts, but they numb it. There's ice, but it still pinches. It's not horrible. It's not like getting a tattoo. Like, that hurts, but it's like a different kind of hurt. It's like a, yeah, I don't know. I'm sorry, I keep touching my hair. I'm putting my hand down. Oh, that's funny. Since you went to Bethel, what kind of worship music do you listen to? What's your favorite song at the moment? I really like Stephanie. Is it Greg Singer? I don't know. I forget her last name, guys. But her new album, Blackout, is pretty good. But any of the spontaneous Bethel worship songs, love. Love, love, love. Where's your dream vacation spot? Oh, that's like maybe the hardest question ever. Come on. I really want to go to Italy, like Rome. You've already been to. They're talking about like vacations. I guess the most beautiful place. Oh my gosh. Wait, hold on, give me a second. Switzerland. Beautiful. It was just so surreal. It was very, very surreal. Like on top of all the mountains and stuff. It's like, what? This exists? Yeah. That's probably the most beautiful spot. The craziest spot, though. Like, I'm talking like, phew. I was gone, I'll admit it. Mexico. It does. Definitely. Would you rather be able to fly or invisibility? Would you rather be able to fly or be invisible? There you go. Just kidding. Fly. Come on, fly for sure. What was it like getting injections?
Would you rather have a mullet or a bowl?
is your stance on the end time prophecies?
Oh man.
I feel like this is too deep. I believe every single thing in the Bible. Everything. There's not one thing I don't believe. For myself, everyone has their own opinion, okay? This is mine. I'm allowed to have my own opinion, so bye to the haters. I believe in Jesus. I believe that he died on the cross for my sins. I believe that he's living inside me. And I believe in the end times. I believe he'll come back. All of that. When we die, I believe we'll go to heaven if we have Jesus in our hearts. One question on here that I saw. Am I religious? No. There is a complete difference between being religious and having a relationship. Okay? I have a relationship. So, I have a relationship with Jesus, with God. I'm not religious. Do I go to church? I hardly go to church, guys. I'll be honest. I did go to school. But do I go to church now? I hardly go, okay? There's a lot of things. Like, I go out on the weekend sometimes, and I drink. Like, am I a virgin? Jesus is love. You show love to others. Like, that's it. You don't need to be trying to push your religion. Oh, I freaking hate that. Religion. Like, that whole thing just makes me, like, squirm on the inside. I'm not religious whatsoever. Okay. Rant. Between each set, it's like quick, it's fast, it's like a HIIT cardio session. Like, I'm sweating buckets after, not buckets, but like I'm sweating after, right? So gym routine, okay. I'll just like do some, like, every week it's a little bit different, but back and biceps with 20 minutes of HIIT cardio after. The next day I might do shoulders. I may do cardio after. Kind of depends. The next day, I'll take a rest. The next day, I'll do legs. Legs. So I'll do glutes and hamstrings. I'll do a lot of compound movements. Compound movements, just, it works more muscles than just, like, targeting one. So like squats, you're working your glutes, your quads, and your hamstrings. So that's a compound movement. Anyway, so we'll do legs, followed by 10 minutes of steady state after, so that there's not as much lactic acid built up. And I'll stretch after always. Always. Well, if I can't, then like I'll stretch later, but stretching. Definitely stretch. I'm sorry, I'm not gonna make this too long. The next day, I'll do chest and triceps. So, I'll do an hour of chest and triceps. And then, either before or after, I'll do like 20 or 30 minutes of cardio. And then, my next day, I'll do abs. So, either I'll do a 2-day. Sorry. Someone just came home, so my dogs are barking like crazy. So, I was talking about the gym. 2 days on, 1 day off. 3 days on, 1 day off type of thing. I hope that helps. And I'll try and do like 2 HIIT cardio sessions a week. If I can. Maybe, yeah. Well, 1 or 2 HIIT cardio sessions. besides ASMR job wise. So I work part time at Popeye Supplements. It's a health supplement store. And I'm a certified personal trainer. So I create meal plans, training programs, macronutrient plans, all customized to your own body. And I also do coaching. So we'll go week to week and adjust things as we go. And for whatever your goals are, losing weight, gaining weight, help people lose like so much weight. So yeah. And I also do custom ASMR videos as well. What is your favorite part about yourself? Obviously, I don't know you personally, but I like how much you care about your viewers. No. My favorite part about myself. Okay. So, I guess I like how open I am. Like with my personality. I used to be really shy. And I just completely came into my own. So, I like that about myself. And I like my drive, like work ethic as well. So, you know, me doing my shows, all that, like, I just, yeah, I guess I just like my drive as well. So, weight have you lost, and what inspired you to lose it? Well, what inspired me was I was friggin' fat, so that inspired me. Actually, Paige Hathaway, if you guys don't follow her. Oh, by the way, I popped a blood vessel in my eye, so that's that freaking thing. It'll go away, but like, yeah, it's pissing me off. How much weight have I lost? Okay, so I've been a lot of different weights. If you're talking from my heaviest weight, which was 220, to my lowest weight, which is 120, like 124, that's like 100 pounds, right? But the thing is, like, I gained after I was like, I'm gonna have to do a whole story on my fitness journey, because it is very, very bumpy. Eating disorder before, like, there's just a lot of different factors, but right now I'm at a comfortable weight. Like, I am like 155 right now, so it's fine, but like, do I still want to get smaller? Yeah.